Hello and welcome to this session on programming IPL in MATLAB. My name is Gunjan and today I'm going to help you with respect to how you can utilize Indian Premier League's data within MATLAB. To begin with, my first job right now is to visit IPLT20.com, which I have already done on my web browser. At the time of this recording, half of the IPL 2020 is over. So as you can see in the standing, 7 matches has been played by each of the team and it is showing a table based on that their performance. Now what we are going to do is we are going to use the statistics and we are going to fetch the data from the IPL T20 website within MATLAB. So how can we do that? This is the main portion with which we are going to begin our part 1 of this series. And once I cover up this explanation, that is, we are successfully able to fetch the data of Indian Premier League, not just for 2020, you will be able to use the same method for other seasons or maybe using all-time records. So once I am done with my portion, Vishakha will take over and she will be explaining how you can utilize this data within MATLAB and how can you create an application based on that. So this video as well as the lesson will be helpful for you in understanding MATLAB, core programming, and then app designer. So what are we waiting for? Let's start learning MATLAB and app designer. So now we have opened our MATLAB. I am using MATLAB R2020B for this. However, you can use a different version of MATLAB. Wherever I am going to use a new function, I'll try and talk about when this function was released, which MATLAB version it particularly include that version or not. And this way you will also get an idea whether this coding is going to work on your particular version of MATLAB or not. To begin with, let me create a new file. I'll simply start with CLC clear and close all. Although we aren't going to go for any plot, so this thing is not required, close all. So I'll just remove this for the time being. And let me save this file as most runs. Now, why I named it as most runs is the first example which shows IPL's website is based on the most runs. So we are going to code and we are going to find out the all the players. This table which you are able to see, we are going to find this data of 100 players, I guess. So these 100 players within MATLAB. In order to do that, the first and foremost thing is you mention the URL. So I am using this 2020 most runs and I have added the URL. Let me increase the size for you. And we can use a function called webread to read the source code for any website on internet. So let me directly go for webread URL and I'll fetch it into data. I'll also open the documentation for it for your reference. So you can see that webread is used to read the content from RESTful web service. The syntax is shown in it. You can use the, like, you can mention the website address and then if you want you can add some parameters. Right now I do not have any parameters, so I am directly using that and I am fetching the data in by default format, which is automatically obtained based on the content type. Now this function of webread was launched in MATLAB R2014B. So if you are using a MATLAB version below 2014B, that is A14A or earlier, I don't think this webread will be compatible for you. In that scenario, I recommend you to check out the URL read function. This URL read function was launched in somewhere around MATLAB R2006 and you can utilize this function instead of webread for doing this same stuff, that is reading the data into MATLAB, the web data directly. So let's jump back to MATLAB now and let me run it. So I have run it. Command window is yet to show the prompt. All right, So now you can see over here the data and the URL. So data is somewhat about 3,95,000 characters. If I show you here, I'm sorry, this is not data. So this is quite a big data and it contains our data set, which is the web source of it. If you want to like understand what really it is, you can just right click on your web browser and you can also use view page source. So this is the page source. If you want to cross check if a player is there or not, let me just try with, let's say, Sam Curran. I randomly took this name using find and we found that this player is existing. Okay, let's go for Sunil Narayan. And then yes, Sunil Narayan was found. So what really is happening is this table within the MATLAB is in a structured format in their web code. Now we are going to feel what really is their structure. We are going to analyze this structure and model that pattern within the MATLAB so that it is easy to extract the data into MATLAB directly from the website of IPL T20. If in case you want to know like what really was this content and you also want to save that part, so there is also a way. For example, if you directly want to save this code into a .txt file, so let's simply open a file, let's say fid is equal to fopen, and let me name this as source code .txt, and I'll open it in the write mode. And then I'll use the fprintf function. I'll use this FID file as a reference. We are going to use the direct data as %s as a string in, and this data would be directly assigned over here. And let's close our file which was open. So FID. So if I run it, you would notice that within the current folder there will be a new file, source code.txt would be created. I'll show you that as I get it. So now jumping back to my folder, and you can see the source code. So over here you are able to see the same source code which we are also seeing over here within the website. If you aren't sure about that, you can use the same method. Like for example, Sunil Narayan, I am copying the name again, going back to this and using find option, and this is obtained. So through this you have now recognized that the source code is containing the table, but the table is not directly available to you. You would also ask that isn't there any simple function which can directly get me a table? Well, there is a function called read table. I'll open the documentation for that. The read table function works if you are directly giving it an input of maybe Excel file or a delimited file where you have a structured data, that is all the data is separated with the same kind of delimitation. So this delimited data should have been in a proper format. That is, for example, in Excel you already know that one column is dedicated to, let's say, name, another column is dedicated to the match plate, and everything is in a properly structured manner, and you know that name and the run, ball face, etc., all are separated by a space or maybe a comma or something else, but which is same. Over here, our delimiter can be a new line character, our delimiter can be a string as well, and it is also changing time to time. Changing time to time, but it is repeating itself. So we are going to create this as a structured manner in which we are going to define that's how our delimiter is occurring, and we will be able to process this entire source code and get the data in the MATLAB. Let's check our source code again over here, data. So this is a very big data set. For me to process it within MATLAB, it's slightly complicated. So I try and use directly the web version over here, and I try to understand how the data is actually created by this website of IPL T20. So the first player name at this moment is KL Rahul. KL राहुल, सो यू आर एबल टू नोटिस दैट के एल राहुल केम अप ओवर हियर. फ्यू थिंग्स विच आई बिलीव आर गोइंग टू बी यूजफुल फॉर अस कुड बी द नेशनैलिटी, द टीम आई डी. लेट मी सी, इज द नेशनैलिटी रिपीटिंग? So I took the keyword of data nationality just to see if the same thing is repeating or not. Okay, so my guess was right. So this is repeating again and again. If I try to refer it with respect to the number shown in my browser, 4 out of 100, 3 out of 100, 2 out of 100. So first player is Indian and KX from KXIP. So this is KL Rahul, an Indian player from Kings 11 Punjab. Second player is again Indian. The name is Mayank Agarwal, so Indian Mayank Agarwal. Third is CSK Overseas and its Fabdu Places. So CSK Overseas and Fabdu Places. So randomly moving, actually it's sequentially moving, but let's say 20th person is Indian from Rajasthan Royals and the name is Rahul Tevatiya. So let's see if the name is coming or not. It's coming. It's ranked at 20th place. So we got a structure to that. That a data nationality part is coming again and again. Now I also want to see how this process is repeating, when exactly it's repeating. So I see over here, it's if it's the beginning portion, this also indicates that we have some data over here in the beginning, and looks like JS row could be our way out delimiter. So the first player over here is starting with this new row, and there are total 100 rows. So 100 players are being ranked in this table, and 100 players are coming up in this part as well. There is one distinguishable feature as well among these 100 players. The first player is always with a picture, but rest of the 99 players are going to be without picture. So it may be that we have to do the analysis of first player differently, but we will try and to create this code as if all the players are we are able to fetch all the players data directly in the same manner. So to begin with, I am directly using the first string over here of data nationality. This is for the example purpose, and I'll show you what we can do with that. So let me comment this for now. We are going to use another function called strsplit. This strsplit is going to take this input of string, and whatever the delimiter we want it to split at, we use that accordingly. So for example, I directly use strsplit and splitting at the data nationality word. So let's assign this into a temporary variable called temp, and let's run it. Let's see what happens. I can see there are 101 cell into it. So if I show you, I can clearly see that the players are actually getting splitted just before the equal word in the data nationality. So you can refer again this portion, data nationality equal. So this word acted as the delimiter, and the whenever this word data nationality was detected, our string took that as our go into the next data set. So it is finding it 101. So the last data is as if even if it did not found the data nationality keyword, so it's able to fetch the entire portion, the remaining portion, into the last column, although this also contains our data. So let's see what can be the beginning factor. Okay, so to get the first player, what I'm going to do is I'll use this string splitter over here and since I am using the portion JS row top layer, this thing should give me only two data, that is two cell array. The first is containing the initial part and second portion contains the data starting from this name. Now with this, what I understand is that we have received 100 data, but entire 100 data starting from the word KXIV is currently in the second cell array. So what we can do is we can use the cell assignment, let's say temp equal to temp of 2. By doing that, we change this temp back to the character array containing the items into it. So if this way you are going to get the data, you also need to make sure that you are also obtaining 100 rows, that is the number of data set. So to do that, what I'm going to do is I'll use temp keyword whenever I feel that the data is being changed, and the moment I feel the data is not getting changed and we can continue with the process data, so I'll change that back to the same name we were using. And right now it's data, and we can add this keyword over here. I am also adding the first space. I know that the player might also change. See, it's not necessary that always the player of KXIV going to be the first ranker. But this is going to be true that all the time the keyword going to be the matching is tr class js row top layer top layer. So I'm just copying that portion, that this portion has already been done. And the second portion is how do we get it, that is 100 rows. So we are going to use the string splitter again. So let's use str split. I can directly pass the second cell array, and what we are going to split at is this keyword js row, which we found that this is repeating, or this is allowing the players to begin with. So let's add this over here and let's see. Now our data is 100 cell array. If I open it over here in the workspace, you are able to see all the players are being shown up. It's an extra data, obviously. So if I show you the data of the first player, for example, it's starting from the word KXIP, the team name, then it's starting telling us Indian, for some other important data like match played and all these information. So we are getting all this data in the MATLAB, but now it's how can we process this data into the readable format or processable format. So make sure that you are going to watch the next video. We are going to cover up how can we convert this extracted data into the processable data of MATLAB.